Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2421. Change the last comma to a period. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question, in a comment at YouTube, they had numbers R1, 000, 00, and they wanted to change the last comma to a decimal point. And thinking about that, there might be numbers that are larger. So you actually have three commas, you want to change to the third comma, or here, a smaller number, there's only one comma, and that's the comma you want to change. So I have two different solutions to this, and I'm curious to see what your solution would be. The first thing I wanted to do was go into text to columns, and in the step three, use advanced and see if I could play with these, but it's not working the way that I want it to work. It's probably working the correct way. It just didn't work out for me. So a trick that we've used before, we take the length of A2 and then subtract the length of A2 after we change all of the commas to nothing, right? So the difference between those two lengths tells us how many commas we have. And then the awesome thing is the substitute function can say replace a comma with a period. This fourth argument is which instance do we want to change? So in this case, we want to change the first comma, but out here we want to change the 1/3 comma thanks to that formula. Now, I do that in two pieces because I want you to understand how this is working. But once you understand it, then really you can just come back here and put it all in one big long formula. But there's definitely other ways to go. And my first thing is, let's just get rid of all the commas. We can put them back later. All right, so the substitute, get rid of every comma, change it to nothing. But we still have an R. And I actually tried to put an array in here. And it didn't work the way I wanted it to work. Maybe with let, I don't know. All right, so my cheap way of doing this is just assume that everything starts with an R. I could have done another substitute. So the mid of A2 starting at 2 for a length of 50, that gets rid of the R. But we're still text, and it's still multiplied by 100. This was 389.4, and now I have 389. And we can solve both of those problems simply by just dividing by 100. The math operation coerces the text back into a number, and then dividing by 100 gets it back to the original amount. From this point, if we want those numbers as numbers, then come into the number dialog launcher, go to currency, in the symbol, scroll all the way down to R. English South Africa will work. Click OK, and you get everything formatted. If you actually need it to be text, the question would have left it as text. Then we can either use the text function with backslash R or the text function with this $RENZA. Both will work. For me, that's the shortest one, easiest to explain, and it has the advantage that we can actually sum things. Like here, we couldn't sum that. But here, using the number format, we can sum and it'll be formatted correctly. Check out my new book, Mr. Excel 2021, Unmasking Excel. If you like these videos, please, down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel 2021.